Subscribe to Civil Steps YouTube channel. Press bell icon to get latest updates.
Next news is regarding mangrove ecosystem. Recently, guidelines on mangrove ecosystem restoration for the Western Indian Ocean regions were released. Now, these guidelines were developed by the member states of Nairobi Convention with support from UNEP. So there are three major stakeholders who are responsible for the development of these guidelines. First is Nairobi Convention itself. Second, the Western Indian Ocean Marine Science Association. And third is the Western Indian Ocean Mangrove Network. So remember these three stakeholders. Now, mangroves. What are mangroves? Mangroves are the diverse group of salt-tolerant plant community of tropical and subtropical intertidal regions of the world, basically occurring mainly between 24 degree north and 38 degree south latitude. They are also referred as tidal forest and belong to the category of tropical wetland rainforest ecosystem. These mangrove forests exhibit varied morphological and physiological evolutionary adaptations to survive the limiting factors imposed by, like, lack of oxygen, high salinity and diurnal tidal inundation, that is flooding, such as succulent leaves, sunken stomata, aerial breathing roots called pneumatophores, vivipari, stilt roots. Now, if you see the types of mangroves formation in India, so there are three types. Number one is deltic mangrove that occur mainly along the east coast. Second is backwater estuarine type that occur along west coast. And third is insular type that occur in Andaman and Nicobar Island. Now, if you see the significance of mangroves, it is very much important. Like mangrove, if you see, they are the breeding, feeding and nursery ground for most of the commercial fishes and crustaceans. Next, they help in protection to the coastline, that is minimizing disasters due to cyclones and tsunami. Also prevent soil erosions, regulating and supporting nutrient cycling also. Another significance is that used as a wood for fuel, construction, fish traps, etc. Also used as traditional medicines to treat disease like malaria, diarrhea, snake bite, etc. It also stores more carbon dioxide than most other forests. So this is another significance of mangroves. Now if you see that mangroves are lost in India, and the major reason are rice, shrimp and oil palm cultivation. This is first major reason. Second is shoreline erosion. This is second. Third, extreme weather events. Fourth, eutrophication. And fifth is coastal development. Clear? So remember these reasons. Now, if you see, mangroves cover 0.15% of the country's total geographical area. And West Bengal has the highest of the India's mangrove cover. Sundarban mangrove of West Bengal is the largest mangrove forest in the world. Next, if you see in the decreasing order of mangrove coverage is Gujarat. So after West Bengal, it is Gujarat. And then Andaman and Nicobar Island. After that, Andhra Pradesh. And after that, Maharashtra. Followed by Odisha, Tamil Nadu, Goa, Karnataka, Kerala. So remember this order. And after Kerala, it is दमन एंड दीयू, एंड फाइनली इट इज पुडुचेरी. सो रिमेंबर दिस ऑर्डर बिकॉज दे कैन आस्क यू इन एन एग्जाम डायरेक्टली. सो इफ यू सी गोदावरी कृष्णा मैंग्रोव्स, बारातंग आइलैंड मैंग्रोव्स दैट इज इन अंडमान एंड निकोबार, एंड पिचावरन मैंग्रोव्स दैट इज इन तमिलनाडु आर सम ऑफ द इंपॉर्टेंट मैंग्रोव साइट्स इन इंडिया. एंड इन इंडिया इट हैज बीन फाउंड दैट वी हैव लॉस्ट 40% ऑफ इट्स मैंग्रोव एरिया इन द लास्ट सेंचुरी, मेनली बिकॉज ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर, एक्वाकल्चर, टूरिज्म, अर्बन डेवलपमेंट एंड ओवर एक्सप्लॉयटेशन. सो सीइंग दिस, गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया हैज टेकन सम इनिशिएटिव. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इंडिया हैज ड्राफ्टेड अ नेशनल स्ट्रैटेजी एंड एक्शन प्लान टू सस्टेनेबली मिटिगेट द मैंग्रोव एंड कोस्टल इकोसिस्टम. दिस इज द फर्स्ट इनिशिएटिव. सेकेंड, कोस्टल रेगुलेशन जोन नोटिफिकेशन अंडर द एनवायरमेंट एक्ट 1986 declared all the coastal stretches up to 500 meter from the high tide line as CRZ, which is very essential for conservation and sustainable management of mangrove forest. So this is a second initiative. Third, Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change put restrictions on the expansion of shrimp farming. So this is the third initiative. Next, Mangrove for Future is Indian initiative with cooperation of IUCN to promote investment in coastal ecosystem conservation for sustainable development. Next initiative is Magical Mangroves. Magical Mangroves join the movement. That is a nationwide campaign launched recently which highlights the significance of mangrove conservation in present times and urges citizens to join the conservation movement. So these are some of the initiatives. Now if you see at state level, for example, Andhra Pradesh Forest Department has formed eco development committees and Vana Samrakshan samitis for the joint implementation of project in mangrove areas. Similarly, Maharashtra became the first coastal state to declare a state mangrove tree species named Sonaraita Aiba or mangrove apple as a symbol to enhance conservation of mangroves. Now we'll see about Nairobi Convention. It is a partnership between government, civil society and private sector working towards a prosperous Western Indian Ocean region with healthy rivers, coast and oceans. Now this convention entered into force in 1996 and is a part of UNEP regional program. Now the convention offers a regional legal framework and forum for intergovernmental discussion that lead to better understanding of regional environmental problem and the strategies needed to address them. Now to address the emerging issues in the region, COP, that is Conference of Parties, have established expert groups and task force such as the Mangrove Network, Coral Reef Task Force, Marine Turtle Task Force and the Forum for Academic and Research Institutions. Also the legal and technical working group. Now remember, India is not the party to this convention. Okay. Inclusion of mangroves in biosphere reserves, World Heritage Sites and UNESCO Global Geopark contributes to improving the knowledge, management and conservation of mangrove ecosystem throughout the world. So this is one of the global initiatives. Similarly, another global initiative, International Blue Carbon Initiative, is a coordinated global program focused on mitigating climate change through the conservation and restoration of coastal and marine ecosystem. Another global initiative is Global Mangrove Watch. Now, it is an online platform that provides the remote sensing data and tools for monitoring mangroves and gives universal access to near real-time information on where and what changes there are to mangroves across the world. So remember these three global initiatives also, apart from Indian initiatives taken by Government of India to preserve or conserve the mangroves.